Hi, I'm Dr. Rajdeep. I'm a dermatologist and dermatosurgeon practicing at Sharma, a skin, hair and nail clinic attached to Chirag Hospital in JP Nagar 2nd Phase, Bangalore. There are certain areas of our body called as intertriginous areas. These are the folds of the body, like the underarms, under the breast area in women, behind the ear, where there's a fold, in between the thighs and the groin, and the natal cleft or the buttocks cleft. So these are all called as intertriginous areas. So because these areas are closed and there's not much ventilation in these areas, sweat tends to collect over there and lead to a condition called as intertrigo. Intertrigo is a condition where there's a mixed infection of bacteria and fungi, and sometimes multiple bacteria may be involved. It may cause itching, it may cause burning sensation, and it may cause pain. Certain other types of skin diseases or allergies like seborrheic dermatitis can also predispose a person to intertrigo. Most of the time, intertrigo is caused when a person is not able to wash those areas and dry those areas because they may be overweight. Also very commonly seen in children, very small infants, because they have a lot of fat and body folds, even on the stomach, etc. it might be seen. In women, this area might be commonly, this area under the breast might be affected, especially if they are wearing very tight clothes, if they are not able to take a bath frequently, if they are sweating a lot in hot climate, etc. So one of the easy methods to take care of this is to keep the area dry. You could use a dusting powder, which is available in medical stores, or you could use a regular talcum powder, which is available in cosmetic shops. This helps to keep the area dry. Also use undergarments which are well fitting but not too tight, and preferably which are made up of some breathable material like cotton or polyester, which allows for breathing and evaporation of the sweat. If you sweat a lot, it would be recommended to change your undergarments frequently and take a bath twice a day. If at all your intertrigo is not responding to these things, you might need a course of antifungals, antibiotics, etc., depending on what your dermatologist decides for you.